Benny Hill. On the stage, couldn't project past row G. You were sitting in row H, he had no effect on it. He could not project. A lot of comedians are basically shy, are really timid, don't want to go on as themselves, want to go on as a character, want to go on as even some of the most brilliant have always wanted to hide behind some kind of artificial mask. He was a vision of loveliness in the early Benny, on the stage, he always had to play a role. I remember going backstage at the Prince of Wales, Benny was starring in a Bernard Dolphin show there called Paris to Piccadilly. He said, what did you think of my Frankie Lane? Now, Frankie Lane was a big popular singer who played the Palladium, and he had huge hits like Mule Train. And so Benny wrote a very funny parody. He was awfully good at that. And did them like Frankie Lane. And I said, you're wonderful. And he said, yeah, I could do that. As Frankie Lane, I could do that. And I said, what are you talking about? He said, well, as Benny Hill, I can't do that. I can't gesture like that. And it's perfectly true. The inhibitions he had on stage were such that that would have been impossible for him. But as Frankie Lane, he could do it.
Friends, good evening and welcome to Opportunity Calls, the show in which we hope to prove once and for all that the stars of today are truly the unknown artists of tomorrow. So here, ladies and gentlemen,
he was the first television comedian to be created by television, in that he wasn't a radio star or a stage star of any significance before TV created him. And so he always felt that he was that television was Dr. Baron Frankenstein and he was its monster.
Ready, action!
It's perfectly true that he was more effective in the studio without the interference of live laughter from the audience. He didn't require that to make him bounce.
It's Tingle's Television, the best in the West. Tingle's Television, the television service that never lets you...
See, Benny came through the lens.
Hello, viewers.
Almost nobody came through the camera lens like Benny. He was in the room with you. And I say his double take into camera was perfect Pavarotti top note. And he was really quite brilliant.
I took my bald-headed Uncle Bert to the cinema for a treat. He dropped his glasses and he searched for them underneath the seat. Now the girl sitting next to him, she looked down, she saw the bald head of my Uncle Bert. And thinking it was her kneecap, she covered it with her skirt.
Benny Hill was always a loner. I mean, we became really good friends, but I always knew there was a barrier there. He never let you get that close. And a man who found it very difficult to relate to other people, but who had a sweet nature.
Thought she'd like it better that way.
He relaxed by going to the homes of middle-aged friends, ladies, and cleaning their houses. It seems an odd way to have a hobby for a comedian.
What a world.
What a place.
What a place.
Ain't you glad you're a member of the human race?
He was always a self-deprecating, kindly, patient man who feared his lack of education was going to let him down, who was terrified of women unless they were socially below him. In other words, he would love to be the knight in shining armor who took out the factory girl, the shop girl, who'd left school when she was 12, and he would be the hero, and he would take her out, and he would take her to the chocolate house in Regent Street and buy her a cocoa.
Gee, thanks, Pat. That was real cruel. Ladies and gentlemen, it's nice to be back with you again.
He once came round to my house when I lived in St. John's Wood, and my secretary, who later became my second wife, and has been my second wife for these 30 years, she happened to be there as a guest. And he'd had, I think, that much sherry when he was drunk. I mean, you only had a sniff of the cork and he was drunk. So he proposed to her. He did. And then he disappeared halfway through the main course. He must have wandered off into the night. I didn't see him again for about 3 weeks, but by that time he'd sent some flowers to Jackie, my secretary at that time, with an apology, saying, I hope I didn't go too far. He was quite a gentleman, you know. He was. He had great style. He just didn't have the polish quite to carry it off.
Never know how much I love you. Never know how much I care. When you put your arms around me, I get a fever that's so hot.
In the late 1950s and early 60s, because the teenage girls of that period had no groups to wow about, the Beatles hadn't arrived, and neither had the Rolling Stones or any of the big American groups as stars, they had to go crazy over domestic people. And they went crazy for Benny Hill, and may I say in all modesty, there was quite a gang of them outside the stage door for me. Called on him, he would always say, you missed the girls. They were just here. There were all these imaginary girls pouring into the place. He did have quite a jolly sex life. It didn't involve, I think, what you would normally expect consummation to represent on a wedding night. I think it involved more the kind of lip service we associate with Bill Clinton. In fact, exclusively that. He used to go down to dance halls, and he'd sit at the bar and order an orange juice and wait for the word to go round. That's Benny Hill. That's Benny Hill. That's Benny Hill. And eventually some young people would be, Benny, enjoying yourself? And the girls would be there, and he would sort out which one was likely to be pullable and pull them.
Look at that, right?
And they go back to... He had a cold water flat in Maidervale. And the girls used to say that if you'd been there three times, you got all three pairs of knickers, the red, the green, and the black. Then if you'd been there six times, you also got the negligees, same colours. And if you'd been there seven times, you got a bottle of Max Factor Primitif. Primitif was a perfume they couldn't sell because no one could pronounce it, so he got whole crates of it for opening chemist shops or something.
I'm all a fucker, I'm a starter when I'm walking with Susie. I'm never knowing where I'm... She needs me, she needs me. Ding my... I'm...
If you watch Benny's early stuff in black and white when he was first with the BBC, the invention, the wonderful things he devised, perfectly televisual ideas that no one could do on stage or in cabaret or anywhere else except on the box, they were wonderfully cunning and devised so well. And some of the sight gags were just stunning. And everyone stood around and said, this guy is just amazing. Was brilliant at constructing the kind of sketches that worked for him, and look what they did for him worldwide. He became the most famous comedian in the world.
Good evening. Here's the news flash.
He's got a light and a sugar, and they're here.
It's true that as time went by, and while he was at Thames, he found that the sexier the comedy, the better it went overseas. So, of course, Benny was going to be accused of sexing up the comedy, and it may well be that towards the end of those shows, and they were becoming very expensive to make, It was easier to put in a sexy gag. But when he was put on the spot, when the younger comedians, and I know this is usually laid at the door of Ben Elton, and Ben denies it, but the young crowd seemed to be saying, Benny is old-fashioned, Benny is sexist, what he's doing is evil. What it comes down to is that Benny couldn't articulate a good defense. He was interviewed by the papers. The interview in the Daily Mail revealed how Benny couldn't grasp what the criticism was about. He didn't get it. So he's defending himself against something he doesn't understand. Last time I ever saw Benny was in the reception at Thames Television down at Teddington. He said, do you remember when we started? You couldn't make jokes about religion, and you couldn't make jokes about sex. He says, today, they're all making jokes about religion, and they're all making jokes about sex. I've been here all these years. I think I've made them something like £100 million, and they've sacked me. And I said, well, it's... that's not so bad. There'll be a feeding frenzy trying to hire you for everything America's got. Yeah, but I like sitting at home. There's some nice hotels in America, Ben. You could even make a home over there. They love you. Yeah, yeah. I like my little flat. He didn't know how much money he'd got. He didn't know how much money he was sending or earning. If he was asked to make a public appearance, he'd do it in exchange for goods. He liked to have something tangible as a result of his turning up to do whatever the service he was, opening a shop or whatever. What was Benny's way? That he was quaint, there is no doubt. That he was a loner, had difficulties in making close contact with people, that's perfectly true.
A thousand hands applaud tonight. I sing my songs, my star shines bright. I stop and smile, I take my bow.